That was very unscouting-like. and I shall not go into it any farther. 1 Corinthians 13, verses 1 through 7, read, "If I speak the languages of men and angels, but do not have love, I am a sounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so that I can move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. And if I donate all my goods to feed the poor, and I give all my body to be burned, but do not have love, I gain nothing. For love is patient, love is kind. Love does not envy. It is not boastful, it is not conceited, does not act improperly. It is not selfish, is not provoked, does not keep a record of wrongs. Love finds no joy in unrighteousness, but rejoices to the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things." Today's day and age, we tend to confuse the word love with passion. But see, love takes many forms. Love is the greatest source of all. For one of the Ten Commandments, the greatest of commandments, perhaps, is to love thy neighbor. Love is friendship, and as God is friendly. So therefore, let us love one another as we are. Let us embrace our diversity. Let us be one body of scouts, so that we can fulfill that great commission that Christ has given to us, to be fishers of men, to go out into the world, and let us be that one body of scouts, that the world may look upon us and see one. We are unified through this uniform. We are unified through His blood. Revelations 3, 23 reads, Romans 3, 23 reads, "For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God." Friends, the only way to have life everlasting is through Christ Jesus. There is no other way, not through deeds, not through actions, but through Christ Jesus. Lucky for us, John 3:16 reads, "For God so loved the world that He gave His one and begotten Son, so that whosoever believes in Him shall have everlasting life and not perish." Now I realize this is a regular for a scout chapel service, but if you don't know Christ, or perhaps you know Christ, but you've strayed from your path to Him, I will stay up here for 10 to 15 minutes after the service, and I will be happy to pray for you. Perhaps you're walking with Christ, but you've got trials in your life. You've got struggles. I will be happy to pray for you. Friends, we are brothers in scouting. We are one body of scouts. Let us be that one body to the world for all of us to see. Now, I'd like for you to pick up the hymn that was passed to you, that is rest on your table.
Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? go back to your hymns tonight, or to Bradshaw tonight, filled with God and His love and His grace. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for Scouting. Lord, thank you for such a wonderful organization that serves millions of young men, not just in the United States, but across the world, all over the world. Thank you, Father, for the week we have had thus far, and for allowing us to have a sane and relevant development of our camp, O Lord. Father, I pray that you would each and every one of the people here tonight be with them as they go back to their tents, be with them as they go to their days tomorrow, as they go home on Friday or Saturday, or whenever it is that they may be going back home. Lord, I pray that you would place your blessings upon this camp and upon everybody here. Thank you, O Lord, for all of your many blessings, for you are so great. In your blessed holy name, I pray. Amen.